Got a gambling problem? It's not you, it's your relatives. Hey folks, Laci Green here for DNews. You're probably already well aware that gambling can be really addictive. What's a fun night on the town for most people can be a really toxic breeding ground for impulsive behavior in about 2-4% of the population. Gambling addiction works just like other types of addiction. The person becomes obsessed and they can't control themselves. It's the ultimate high. They'll continue to pursue the high even as they're running into financial problems and tearing their family apart. Some might even break the law or steal in order to recover their losses. Now, even though problem gambling is commonly seen as a personal failing by the mainstream, scientists have found that there's real biology behind the behavior. For many years, scientists thought that gambling was a matter of impulse control. I mean, claiming that gambling was like alcoholism was pretty controversial in the 70s and 80s. But last year, psychiatrists moved problem gambling to the addictions chapter of the DSM, reflecting our developed understanding of addiction in the brain. So this week, scientists have added more to that growing body of research about gambling, and they found some pretty important stuff. In a new study published in the Journal of Clinical Psychiatry, scientists have found that having a relative with a gambling problem puts you at 8 times the risk of developing one as well. Now, amongst those with gambling problems, 11% of the relatives had pathological issues. Compare that to the non-addicted population, where only 1% of their relatives have gambling problems. But here's the real kicker. Amongst the relatives of those with a gambling problem, the scientists also found a much higher prevalence of behavioral disorders, like antisocial personality disorder and social anxiety. And those disorders in the relatives didn't necessarily overlap with the pathological gambling itself. There were some overlaps, though, with mood disorders. In the pathological gamblers, rates of bipolar disorder, major depression, and substance abuse were much more common. So what this suggests is that problem gambling and some psychiatric disorders may have some kind of shared genetic cause, which could hold the key to effective treatments and help us better understand psychiatric disorders in general. But scientists aren't quite sure what genes are at play yet. Thanks for watching DNews, everyone. We'll be back soon with more science updates.